Hello students, today in this video we are going to discuss about energy. Now all of you know that energy is very important for us, and on earth the main source of energy is sun. So all the forms of energy, almost all the forms of energy on earth are derived from sun, directly or indirectly. Now when we use the term energy in science, the energy has precise meaning. Okay, energy has precise meaning. Now we can understand it with some examples, like when a fast moving ball hits a stationary wicket, then what happens? The wickets fall. Okay, thrown away. The wickets are thrown away. Now, when we raise some object through some height, so it gains, gets the capability to do work. Okay, we can understand it with the help of an example. Suppose if you raise a hammer, okay, and if you hit the nail with the hammer after raising it, what happens? Nail drives the nail into the wood. Means जो nail है वो अंदर चली जाती है, ठीक है, दीवार में या wood में, जहाँ भी आप इसको लगा रहे हैं. Similarly, when a kid or a child wins a toy car, now what happens? Okay, when you release it, the car starts moving. Okay, similarly, if you take a balloon and if you press it hard, what happens? It changes its shape. Okay, it changes its shape. And if you press it hard, it explodes. So in all these examples, what we see? That these objects are acquiring the capability. They are acquiring capability to do work. Okay. They are acquiring capability to do work. So it means an object which have capability to do work, it possesses energy. It possesses energy. Okay, now here one important thing. The object which does the work loses energy, and the object on which work is done, it gains energy. We can understand it with the help of example of nail and hammer. When you hit the nail with the hammer, hammer loses the energy, okay, and nail gains energy. Okay, so in this way energy is transferred from hammer to nail, and then in response to that nail moves inside the wood. So in this way we can say that energy is the capacity to do work. So whatever object possesses energy can do work. So if you have to define energy in scientific terms, we can say that an object having capability to do work possesses energy. Okay, now next is so in short we can say that capacity of doing work is called energy. Now what will be the unit of energy? The unit of energy will be same that of work, that is joule. The unit of energy will be joule. Now next thing is, how will you define 1 joule energy? It's very important. How will you define 1 joule energy? So it is the energy required to do 1 joule work. 1 joule work करने के लिए जितनी energy required होगी, that is called as 1 joule energy. And one bigger unit of energy is kilojoule, and 1 kilojoule equals to 1000 joule. Now, what are the various forms of energy? There are various forms of energy, like these are mechanical energy, which includes potential energy and kinetic energy, about which we will discuss in the next video. Then there are other forms of energy like heat, okay, then chemical energy, then electrical energy and light energy. So these are the various forms of energy. Our food contains chemical energy, okay. Coal, petrol also contain chemical energy. All of you know about the other forms of energy also. In next video we'll discuss about the types of mechanical energy, that is potential energy and kinetic energy, and the expression, the derivation of expression to find out kinetic energy and potential energy.